Welcome back to another video. If you're new, hi, my name is Michi and this is my channel, this is my kingdom. If you're not, what's up my G, how was your week? I hope you're doing okay. In today's video, I did something which I would have never guessed that I would have done this. I got out of bed and I took myself outside, I know, to take pictures. I'm just as surprised as you guys are. I decided to finally show you guys how I take my pictures for Instagram, but I thought it would be really boring to do that indoors because it's not that fun. Everyone knows all the backgrounds, or I'm tired of them, even though, you know, there's still untapped potential. But I decided it would just be fun to do this outside. And yeah, I show you guys a different, you know, angle, change the angle, switch it up a bit. So that's what I did, and in today's video I'm going to show you guys not only how I take my pictures for Instagram but also how I edit them. Let's just jump into the taking of the pictures. I'm just going to start by taking selfies with the sky in the background and maybe with the trees from some angle. And then I don't know, maybe I'll do some pictures standing, maybe I'll go sit over there and take some pictures sitting down and see how those turn out. So I'm done taking pictures with the sky behind me like I said I would, and now I'm going to go sit down there and I'm going to take some more snaps. Ooh. Cute. See, it kind of works. I'm going to put the camera down in the road where the cars will be passing and I'm going to take pictures, I guess. I don't know why I'm being so brave today. Yeah, so I'm going to sit here and be cute, and I don't even care who's watching anymore. So that location was an utter failure. I didn't like it. Now I'm going to try to take some of those cute, like from above in the grass type photos and see how I like them. I've never done anything like that before, so pray for me. This better not mess up my hair or else I'm going to be mad at all of you who take such pictures, and I will come fight you. But yeah, I already don't like it. What do I do? I'm going to pack up my little set here, I guess, and I'm going to go back inside and show you guys how I edit my photos. Okay, now that I'm back indoors, I have taken a bunch of pictures. The first tip is always to take a lot of pictures, by the way. It always helps to take as many pictures as possible so that I have all the options. You know, it's my one, you are struggling, you are hustling, you have done your makeup, you have worn your outfit, you go outside and you take 5 pictures and you hate all 6 of them. It should never be like that. I would say about 70 pictures, to be honest with you guys. If I'm being very particular, I might even go all the way up to like 150. The first thing I do is I flip all my photos. If you've ever taken a picture, well, I have an iPhone. Maybe it's the same on other phones, I'm not completely sure. But if you've ever taken a picture and then when you go back into your gallery and you look at it and it looks like different, it looks like it's been flipped, that's what most phones do. And that's what my iPhone does with the front camera. And I hate that, because when I angle my pictures, yeah, like I'm taking my pictures, I'm depending on my reflection to see whether the picture is nice. So now if you go and flip it, it'll be bent. I won't like that. So the first thing I do is flip literally all my photos. If I take 170 photos, then I will flip each and every single one of them. And the app I use for this is Snapseed. I use Snapseed because the quality remains great, unlike other apps which I have tried to use. And also it's pretty easy to use. I use it for more than flipping photos, but in today's video I'm just going to show you guys how I use it to flip photos. So I pretty much flip everything, and instead of using the save or the save and copy option, I export the photos. So after I've exported all the pictures, I just go back into my gallery and I delete all the ones that my camera flipped. So now I'm left with exactly what I was seeing when I was taking the photos. And that's what I want, that's what I like, that's what I need. The next thing I do is pick my favorites. So I go into my camera roll, my gallery, and I go through all the pictures and I select the ones I like. Here I'm just going to do it really quickly because I'm trying to, you know, just show you guys, but it usually takes me more time than this because I look at the different pictures, I delete the pictures afterwards. I delete the ones that, you know, like if I've done the same pose twice, I don't need 2 poses like that. I see which one has better lighting, which one where my concealer is looking sensible, which one where my lipstick is, you know. Yeah, and I select my favorites. After I've selected my favorites, I use Facetune to just tweak my pictures. Now, listen, yeah, listen. Pay attention. There's absolutely nothing wrong with editing your pictures as long as you're completely transparent about it. You know what I mean? I could leave my pictures like this. I could just leave them, you know, without doing all this extra stuff. But I did not spend 1 hour and 30 minutes blending this foundation for it to look bumpy, okay? I did not do that, and that's not the vibe I'm going for. So I just, out of preference, I always tweak my photos. It's not a lot, but you can do a lot if you want. Hello, it's your face, it's your Instagram, as long as you're not lying to people and trying to make it seem like, you know, that's natural, that's exactly how you are. I'll be very honest and very open. I edit all my pictures because editing is fun for me. It's like it's the best thing. It just depends on the picture, depends on the mood I'm going for and stuff like that. So I use Facetune, and the first thing I do is I defocus. Sometimes I do this, other times I don't. It's nice for when I'm indoors, especially outside. I think I like my backgrounds to show because, you know, lots of bright colors and stuff like that. But indoors, my background is usually boring like this, so I don't mind blurring it out. So I use the defocus tool and I just cover the entire area outside me, and then, you know, I erase the little bits where maybe it's touching me, and I always reduce it to like 25 or 20, somewhere there. After I defocus, the next thing I do is retouch. I use the smooth tool and I just go over things where I'm feeling like here my concealer judas'd me, or like my skin is acting up, or, you know, things like that. I go over those areas and I always reduce it, because you see, the thing about this smooth tool is, yeah, I can tell, like we can tell when you use it on your pictures. Some people are out here just smoothening until the picture looks like you took it with candid camera. No, like, be realistic about it. Skin has texture and that's fine. So you shouldn't go and smooth it over until it's looking like you basically scrubbed all the features off your face. That doesn't make any sense. I still want my pictures to look, I want them to look good, okay? I just want them to look perfect to me. So yeah, don't over smooth your pictures. That's hella annoying. It doesn't look cute at all. And then the next thing I do is use the details tool. And this has got to be my favorite thing to do. I just go over and detail my concealer, my edges, if I've done my edges. I go over, you know, the little hair clips in my hair, this little nose ring, my necklaces, anything that I want to pop, because that's what the details tool does. And this is the only function where I actually increase the value of whatever I'm doing, because it does look mwah. And yeah, I just clean it up and make it look extra neat, extra, you know, it's me, things have to look sensible. The next thing I do after I'm done smoothing out my face and I've done my details, I just save the photo and open up another app. So I use VSCO to add filters to my photos, to add grain. Sometimes I use it to crop my pictures, because it's also one of those apps that doesn't reduce the quality of your photos. If you edit lots of pictures, you know that sometimes passing a photo through so many apps can compress and compress the quality until it looks completely terrible by the time you're done. And I don't want that to happen. So I use VSCO. I import the pictures that I'm, you know, done editing, and I always try out some of the filters because sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. I don't leave them at this high of a value. It's always at 12. I always reduce it to like 3 or 2.5, sometimes 6 if you know the picture needs that much help. But for these pictures, I'm not going to add any filter. I think they're really nice just the way they are. So I reduce the exposure because, you know, reduced exposure just makes pictures look better in my opinion. And then I increase the saturation, because what I see, how vividly I see colors, isn't always how they appear when you take a picture. You know, the camera, it doesn't, yeah, you know what I'm trying to say, it's not always that mwah. So I increase the saturation, and then I sometimes increase the warmth, but these pictures are pretty warm because I took them in the sun, obviously. And then I'm just going to tint these pictures pink slightly, because you know that's the vibe I was going for. I was going for like pink and cuteness. And then I'm pretty much done. If I want to take the pinkness a step further, I go into this, I don't even know what the tool is called, but basically you can use it to like, I don't know, tint your shadows or your highlights specifically. And so I might like tint the shadows red or purple, whatever I'm feeling like doing. And then I save the picture. A cool thing about VSCO also is that for me who edits multiple pictures at a time, I can just click on the picture and then copy the edit and then paste it onto all the pictures I'm editing. And that makes it so convenient, because I just have to edit one picture and it's magic, all of them are edited. But yeah, for these three, I'm just going to click on them individually and see if maybe I have to adjust certain things. For these, I didn't have much to adjust, so I'm going to save them to my camera roll. And then they're ready for posting. And that's my entire editing plus taking pictures routine. If you try any of these things, or if you learn something new, you should let me know. Or like if you post the pictures on Instagram, you should tag me and tell me that you did da 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 da. Because I always find it so fun when people learn stuff from me. It's always very amusing. So that's basically it for this video. I hope you guys learned something. If you did, let me know in the comments down there. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and your family and their families and their friends. And yeah, you guys have a great week. Bye.